Welcome back to another video. If you're new to the channel, I'm Rio. Today, as you can see, I have another Jordan jersey video. This is part three of the Jordan jersey series, or Jordan collection series. I'm not entirely sure what I'm gonna be calling it. Part one was the North Carolina Tar Heels Mitchell and Ness jersey. Part two, I went through all of the Bulls jerseys that I have. So all the Bulls years from 1984 rookie year to the 1998 last year with the Chicago Bulls. Today I have all of the All-Star jerseys. I have 8 in total. Just a heads up, this channel is not dedicated to jerseys. This is not a jersey collection channel. Last year I got into Mitchell and Ness jerseys, and prior to that I was mainly buying like Champions and Nikes. And being a Jordan fan, I always wanted to have a collection of high quality Jordan jerseys. So sometime last year I just started and really didn't stop until I got everything that I wanted to have, which now I feel like I do. If you are someone who's looking for content that is mainly dedicated to jerseys, this channel is unfortunately not that. However, there are lots of other guys out there that do make content similar to that, or make content that you may be looking for in that realm. Check out the Bulls years video. I mentioned quite a few guys in there, but I'm also gonna drop some links down below in this video so you can check out some of those channels and, you know, follow some of those guys, because they know way more than I do and they have way bigger collections, and they just don't do NBA jerseys or keep it strictly with Jordan. If you wanna see some of my other jerseys that I have in my collection that I've bought, I have a couple other videos. I have a selection of Iverson. I have 2 or 3 videos of all the other swingman jerseys that I have or bought in my collection. So check those out. I'll link them up here in the top right for the cards. And I'm also gonna drop them down below in the description section as well. Now that's out of the way, let's hop into these jerseys. So I have 8 All-Star jerseys in total, from the beginning all the way until the end. So let's hop into it. First up, we have the 1985 All-Star jersey. Of course, this would have been Jordan's rookie year. As far as where these All-Star games were played, I'm not entirely sure what the location was. This particular game was February 10th, 1985. This was considered the freeze-out game. As some of you guys would know, Isaiah Thomas, Magic Johnson, and George Gervin all conspired to basically keep the ball away from Jordan, rookie Jordan, because they felt like he was a little bit too cocky. He was a new kid on the block. He was a rookie and of course went on to win rookie of the year. And some of the other guys, some of the veterans, felt like he was a little bit too big for his britches and they wasn't feeling him. He had the whole league buzzing. Chicago was going crazy. They went from not selling out arenas to selling out every single game because, you know, he was in town and he was balling. What I like about this particular jersey is that everything on this jersey is screen printed. One thing I like about Mitchell and Ness always tries to keep their authentic jerseys as close as they can to the original, and I like the fact that they did this. Now, all of the details in this one is almost like in a matte finish screen print. I don't know if that's how they were originally, I'm not entirely sure, but I think it gives it a unique touch. This one does have the stars going along the side of the jersey, and if I flip it around here, you can see we have Jordan 23, and yeah, so this was the 1985 All-Star jersey, and we're gonna move on to the next one. As you can see, this one looks a lot like the previous jersey, and this is gonna be the 1988. I'm trying to get it off the top of my head, but I'm not sure. Yes, 1988. And this game was on February 7th, 1988. This one looks a lot like the previous jersey that I just showed you. The style of the jerseys were the same, but it does have some differences on it. The screen print on this one, or the heat pressing rather, it's a more of a shiny vinyl material almost. But this one, we have the NBA logo stitched on the upper left chest. The one previously did not have that. The stars are on the front side. The other one, they were actually along the sides of the jersey. Yeah, I think those are some of the main differences. And of course, the back here looks like that. Very similar, look at the back, you can see that. You can kind of see that difference too, that one of them actually has more of a shinier finish to it than the other one. This jersey, the 1985 one, also do have slits at the back of the jersey. And this one is like a traditional jersey and they're on the side. This one is more of a heavier material too. When I feel them, this one is definitely a heavier jersey. Seems like the type of polyester that was used is different. And I'm not entirely sure if that's how it was back in the day, but the quality of the 85 one feels like it's a better quality material jersey, if that makes sense. The following year, we have the 1989 NBA All-Star jersey. This date was February 12th, 1989. As you can see, this one looks a lot like the previous two, but it's just a different color way. Of course, we have a red base here opposed to the white. NBA logo on the top left. All of the screen printing is almost like the 85 one. It's almost done in like a matte finish. It's very much like the previous years, just we have the stars along the side of the jerseys, as you can see. This game, I feel like Jordan wore the Bred 4s, which back then they were called the Black Cement 4s. The back, of course, looks like that. So pretty much the same exact thing. But anyway, this is the 1989 All-Star jersey. Let's move on to the next one. Here we have the 1991 All-Star Game jersey. And as you can see, this one looks a lot different than the previous three. So this year, of course, was a different style jersey. I'm not entirely sure if 90 was like this or the previous year, I don't know. And this was on February 10th, 1991. What I like most about this one is that the style of the jersey was extremely unique. The NBA with the star behind it and the All-Star is all sublimated in the jersey, which means it's a part of the fabric. So all of that stuff here is dyed into the fabric. And then the 2-3 and then the NBA logo is stitched. And then we have the stars up here, which are also sublimated into the jersey, which I think was super, super dope. NBA logo, the 2-3 and then the jock tag are the only things that's actually stitched on the front. Because the stars were on this jersey, they had to raise the NBA logo. So it looks a little bit weird, but still dope nonetheless. And then of course we have the back of it, Jordan 23 and red. That was the 1991 All-Star Game jersey. Let's move on to the next one. Here we have the 1993 All-Star jersey. And as you can see, this one looks a lot like the previous one. Of course, it's just in a blue colorway. The NBA, the All-Star with the star behind it, just like the previous jerseys, all sublimated. We don't have the stars here on this one, so the NBA logo's right where it should be. Everything is really the same, except for it's just a different color. Of course, we have the 2-3 stitch with the Jordan arched over in white, which is also stitched. All of the jerseys that you've seen thus far, just a heads up, they're all size medium for any of you guys that are wondering. For size reference, I'm about 6'1", 170 pounds. So if you're looking for help in size, and hopefully that can help you, I basically just went true to size to what I normally wear. Most of my tops, unless I'm going for oversized, or a size medium. Some people like to wear jerseys oversized, so if you do want that, just size up. Or if you already wear your clothes oversized, just go to what you usually wear. Every jersey you've seen thus far is one of the previous runs of these All-Star jerseys. You may notice that some of the newer ones that are being sold has a different type of jock tag where it's bigger and it says authentic on it. I personally didn't want those for these. If you see the Bulls years, the previous video of the Jordan jerseys, all of those jerseys were the newer ones which said authentic. I feel like there was a difference in quality with the All-Star jerseys with some of these. I don't know. I bought this one originally in the newer run. I just didn't like it. The material was just so much different, so I ended up just getting this instead. This particular jersey, I don't know if it has a production year on it. It does. This was 2016, and the new ones are done in, I think, 2020 or 2021. This was the 93, was it? I forgot that quick. Yep, 93. So of course we know Jordan retired for a year and a half and then came back in the 95 season in March, but he didn't play that year in the All-Star game because he came after the All-Star game. So he didn't play in another All-Star game until 96, which was this jersey right here, which is probably my favorite All-Star jersey ever. The colors I think are dope. They're amazing. Another location of this one is because the way they did it was just very reminiscent of where they played. And this was in San Antonio. And as you can see, of course, this jersey does have the newer style jock tag on it, which you can see has the blue authentic underneath it. This game was February 11th, 1996. This particular jersey has some stories behind it as far as Mitchell and Ness releases. I think one of the original releases of this jersey had a mistake on it, so they had to pull those and redo it. From what I understand, the two on the front and the two on the back were upside down. They were flipped. I guess someone made a mistake. Those jerseys, they're really, really hard to find. And if you do find them, you're paying a ton of money for them. I think when I was in the search for this jersey, I came across a guy on eBay who had the one with the upside down two for like 5 racks or something. It's crazy. I wanted to get the jersey that didn't have the newer style authentic on it. Even without the upside down two, those are still going for a lot of money. I think the person went over like 5 something for it. And I'm not spending that much money for a jersey. Heck, I spent enough money for this one already as it is. For that reason, this is one of the most coveted All-Star Game jerseys. And if you have one of those original ones, you have a gem on your hands because those are extremely unique. As you can see, the NBA logo is on the other side on this one here, opposed to being on the left chest. And essentially that's it. The 2-3 is double stitch, NBA All-Stars double stitch. This appears to be like a vinyl application. And of course the Jordan and the 2-3 at the back is also double stitch. And we have the sides, which I think is probably one of the doper things about the jersey, that stretch material there. This was All-Star Game 96. Let's move on to the next one. Here we have another one that looks a lot like the first two that you saw, but there are some differences. Looking at this, you see the same exact looking jersey. However, this one was worn in 2003. And as you guys would know, of course, Jordan came back for the 2001, 2002, 2002, 2003 series with the Washington Wizards. So this is his last year playing the All-Star game with the Wizards. You can of course tell by the Wizards patch at the top of the back of the jersey. The story goes with this one, and I don't know all the details. Check out Mighty Mouse Fan 78. I mentioned him in the last video. This dude has an amazing collection. And also King Leonidas, I think they both mentioned this in some videos. Apparently Mitchell and Ness never got the licensing to produce anything with the Washington Wizards on it. So when they made this jersey and put it out to the public, they had to pull it because they weren't cleared to sell this. This is a rare find, is something that is kind of hard to come by. I hope that Mitchell and Ness at some point can get the license to produce some Wizards jerseys, especially some Jordan jerseys that he played, you know, wearing, because I would like to grab some of those. I think that's all I'm really missing that I really want is some of those Jordan years jerseys with the Wizard. One of the things that makes this different than the first two, let me grab those, is that although the jerseys are essentially the same in their actual colorway, the 1985 jersey has the stars along the sides of the jerseys with the slits at the back. The screen printing is more of a matte finish. This one is a shiny finish, like I mentioned earlier. And then this one, everything is stitched. Well, not everything, but the NBA All-Stars is double stitch. The numbers are single stitch. Of course, the NBA logo up there is stitched. The stars on the side are screen printed. And then the back is single stitched as well. So it gives you a different look than these, because these don't have anything stitched except for the NBA logo on the 1988 jersey. So although the three of them look the same, they do have some varying differences, which is why I wanted to grab them. And then of course, this one being his last actual All-Star game is a special one for that reason. And then the date of this game was February 9th, 2003. As you can see, this last one looks a lot different than all the other ones, because this wasn't a game worn jersey. This one was a practice jersey. This style of jersey was utilized in 97 as a practice jersey in Cleveland. The graphic on the front, which is screen printed, says All-Star Weekend, Cleveland 97. NBA logo top left is screen printed. And the jock tag reads 1997 NBA All-Star Michael Jordan. And of course it has the authentic tag on there. What makes this jersey so dope, in my opinion, is not anything on the front, it's the back of it. The back of the jersey has that big 2-3 in that North Carolina blue, Tar Heels blue, whatever you want to call it, baby blue, light blue. I think that 2-3 is just so dope. It's so clean. Of course, there's a lot of different sneakers that you can rock with that, and it has the Jordan arched over the top there. During my time of looking for this jersey, I came across some of the originals, or maybe some original remakes of the original. I'm not entirely sure if they were or not, but they were going for some hefty prices and they literally look just like this. So I think it's pretty dope that Mitchell Ness was able to create something so close to that version. It is reversible, of course. So this side being the, I guess, the away side, and then the opposite side is going to be the home side, which is white. So let me flip that inside out for you. The white side has NBA All-Stars in that light blue with the orange back shadow. NBA logo over there, screen printed, top left corner screen printed. This one does not have the jock tag, so this is the inverse side. And flipping around, just as dope as the other side with the black Jordan, the 2-3, which has the black border on this one. The opposite side had the white border, of course. So this was the All-Star jersey portion of this series. The first one was the North Carolina Tar Heels jersey. Then I did the Bulls years in the second, and this one was the All-Star jersey. Coming up in this series, I have the Olympic jerseys, I have some shooting shirts, and I have some jackets, and I think that'll probably cap it off. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Again, this channel is not dedicated to jerseys. I want to make sure I remind you guys, if you only care about jerseys, this channel is not for you. If you have interest in other aspects of style and fashion, check out the channel. Hopefully you can see some things that there that you like. And if you like anything you see, feel free to subscribe and turn on your post notifications. Every time I drop a video, you're going to be notified. That covers it for this video. I have some more episodes in this series coming at some point, so stay tuned for those. Thanks again for watching. I'm gonna catch you guys on the next one. Peace.